I just threw little she balls in here with Sweet Home, so she can have some goat time. She's showing all the right instincts. That mama's not sure about her, but yeah, she's already not too worried. There's certain kind of postures and body language that you want to see from a dog that's supposed to be a livestock guardian, and she's showing it. Sweet Home is only half Turkish Congo, so she's actually less livestock guardian than she balls, really, I think. You'd have to sort of talk about, oh, let's see that. That could get her in trouble. Now, that's playful. But that, where she laid down like that when she got there, that's what you want to see. She's like, I want to play, but I don't want to eat you. That's a good example. When she got to her, she laid down, and it was totally, I don't know, I have a word for it, but that is what you want to see. She ran over there like I thought. Maybe for a minute they were both going to chase, which can happen, right? Because they're all cousins of the wolf, so it's kind of a fine line a lot of the time. But that body language there, that laying down, and I don't really want to hunt you kind of gesture, that's what you want to see. But there's an old saying in dogs, which I tell people a lot, which is very true, which is two dogs is four times as much trouble as one. And that's a pack thing. You know, you can have an individual dog that won't roam, two individual dogs that won't roam alone, put them together, all of a sudden they're gone. You can have two dogs that are okay with stock alone, put them together, all of a sudden they're chasing something around, starts out as a game. It can go south. So I try to be real careful about that. And this is one of those transitions from one dog to two. So I was watching it anyway. I thought, well, let me record it. At least it's not another silly ass puppy video, which I kind of want to get away from. I want to make these a little more educational or interesting or telling, and a little less of like, oh, here's these cute puppies, right? Shenanabitch? Yes. This is half and half. These are my replacement Congo Borbo female, Sweet Home here, who's got to be getting close to a year. And this pup, hey, don't put your feet on me. Don't put your feet on me. She's probably only 4 months. Hey, don't put your feet on me. I like her a lot, but she's really handy. She really likes to touch you, which I can't have because the bottom of her feet are always dirty. Yeah, I love that you want to touch me, but I like my clothes clean. So, I think I can walk away from this. Get back to doing stuff. Hey, fuck you. She keeps putting her feet on my shoes. Don't do that. I think she knows that gets her attention, even if it's bad attention. Don't touch me. I love you too, but don't touch me. I think these two are gonna be all right, but I'm not far away. If something starts going on, I'll get a warning. Anyway, there's something other than a silly ass puppy video for those who are getting bored of those, and I hope that there are significant numbers of you that do, because there's really better things to video.